faccio questo
Why do I
tipo
make
di
this type
film,
of
che
film?
faccio dei film così
Why do I make films that are so cruel and disquieting?
Me lo chiedono, devo
I must say, I often
dire,
ask myself the same question, because my imagination isn't all like that. I like to laugh, to joke, to listen to music. So why do I do it? I don't know. Perhaps because it's the darker side of myself, the monster that's inside me. Sometimes it's nearer the surface and it emerges and takes over all my other thoughts, my normal and more relaxed lifestyle. Sometimes I do have these strange ideas which disturb me and even frighten me, thoughts that come from deep down inside me.
Penso mi vengono dal profondo.
When you've been following flights of wild imagination, it's difficult to come back to Earth. It's very difficult. People ask me how I choose the films I make, the themes, the subject matter. Honestly, I don't know. There's no particular moment in which I decide what film to do. Sometimes I get carried away, almost literally. I get bitten by a bug, which is the idea for a new film I want to make. Other times the fever isn't too high and I have to work on the idea to develop it. More than anything else, I wander around. I look about. Solitude is the master for all my films, because solitude enables you to concentrate, to get into that strange world which is often so perverse and cruel.
Entrare in quel mondo così strano, perverso, a volte crudele.
But Dario Argento isn't only an author. He's also a producer and has produced films with other directors. For example, Zombie, directed by Romero, Demons and Demons 2, directed by Lamberto Bava, La Chiesa, The Church, and La Setta, The Sect, directed by Suavi. What difference is there, if any, between the films directed by Dario Argento and those directed by others?
I feel there's a big difference between the films I write and produce alone and those that I also direct. The main difference is that when I direct, I take part in every stage of making the film. Those that I produce only are directed by other people. And since the direction sets the style and soul of a film, they have an atmosphere that reflects the personal style of the other person. For example, Bava with Demons, Suavi with La Setta, and Romero with Zombie. I love the films that I produce and don't direct because, in some cases, they deal with themes that I haven't got the courage to deal with or because I'm not ready for them. I have a lot of admiration and affection for people who manage to handle films like this.
Affetto per colui che invece questi temi riesce a mettere in scena, cioè certi temi molto horror.
There are certain horror themes that I'm not ready to deal with yet. But I like to know about them and see them portrayed in other people's films. And then, perhaps, one day, I'll have a go myself.
As a producer, Dario Argento made another film in America after Zombie. This other film was a very special work entitled Due Occhi Diabolici, Two Evil Eyes. A film in two parts, the first part directed by Romero, the second by Dario Argento himself. During the shooting, Dario Argento worked with some of the best-known American technicians, such as the special effects wizard Tom Savini, renowned for films like Friday the 13th and The Night of the Living Dead. In addition, this was the first time that Dario Argento had directed a film based on a subject that wasn't his own. In fact, the inspiration for much of Due Occhi Diabolici came from a story by Edgar Allan Poe.
Sergio Stivaletti, the makeup artist for Phenomena and Demons, always begins with a sketch based on scientific research. Final creations are the result of careful anatomical studies. The screenplay of Phenomena called for a really horrible monster. He had to be small, but the costume, including a heavy mask, made it impossible to use a child. So, Davide Marotta, a midget, was chosen for the role. This is the mechanical dummy used in the underwater scene.
Io realizzo effetti speciali, soprattutto nei film di Dario Argento. Dario mi chiama quando ha bisogno di effetti che prevedono la presenza di meccanismi.
Many of the special effects used by Dario Argento involve the use of mechanical effects. Dario calls me when he sees the need for special mechanisms. For example, in the film Opera, he needed mechanical crows, because real crows wouldn't perform in the scene the way he wanted them to. It dealt with the crows attacking the assassin in the film. Obviously, real crows wouldn't do it. This is a situation in which the production often finds itself. For example, Demons 2, or in another of Dario's productions, The Sect, other animals, such as the rabbits and the birds, needed the same requirements. The same problems arise when you require monsters. Unlike animals, monsters require extensive internal mechanisms, at least in the cases where I'm called, in order to allow creatures such as these to seem independent.
Anche nella chiesa avevamo il problema delle creature, in quanto nel film si vedono, sia pure più a livello onirico, delle creature che ogni tanto appunto appaiono qua e là nel film. In particolare la creatura
in the film The Church we had the problem of these mythological creatures that had to come to life quite often. In particular, the demon goat, a most sophisticated creation. It was resolved by a combination of makeup and special mechanisms. A costume was worn by an actor that was made of a complex material in that it was foam latex, which required an elaborate process. The actor wore the outfit, but the mechanical movements of the goat's face were controlled by a technician. The movements were by electrical and mechanical remote control, so that from a distance, the facial expressions of the demon goat would be controlled by those who could see them. Other creatures in the film used the same techniques because we found it the best way to go. For example, the monster that comes out of the holy water, as well as others.
Che succede in nome di Dio?
Il film di Dario non vi è solo il problema degli effetti meccanici o di make-up, ci sono anche altri effetti che diciamo sconfinano in un campo che si potrebbe definire delle riprese speciali, che possono essere o in stop motion o in altro tipo di
Dario's effetti. Films benefit not only from the use of technical mechanisms and make-up, but also on special shots such as stop motion or on other optical effects. For example, in a scene where an actress has to have an insect inserted in her nose, there was not only the problem of having her head seem real, which it obviously could not be, but also the problem of getting the insect to crawl in the nose, as well as how to shoot the scene. We succeeded by combining two special effects. One was optical and the other was makeup. The head was cast and remote controls were placed inside. And then sophisticated pseudo-animation was used for the bug. Optical effects were used to resolve other seemingly simple scenes in The Sect, such as a lunar eclipse. Obviously, one cannot wait for a real lunar eclipse. This was another special assignment which I resolved. Basically, the trick was done by having a vertical camera film designs of photographs, utilizing various filters. In this manner, one can create quite an array of fantastic images, like planets, or, as in this particular case, an eclipse of the moon.